good afternoon. My name is Teresa M. Merrick, and I'm from Bellevue, Nebraska. And if you want to contact me, I'm at sam68123@cox.net. So sam68123@cox.net.
Great, Teresa. So will you tell us about your background as it relates to the Highland Games? And then I'd also like to know a little bit more about your military background.
All right. Well, this is my 13th season competing in the Highland Games. I got started in it as a way to go to a games where my colleague, Sean Betts, a former pro, was throwing in Scotland in 2007. I got a chance. They had a women's division there. I'd been powerlifting, and I asked him if they had a women's division, and he said, oh, they're so cool in Scotland, your husband could show up, and they'd let him throw. So I got my taste in 2007 in Scotland, and started to come into the States, and then I had wanted to qualify for Masters World Championships at the time, or I had to ramp up my participation. So I usually I had to go 5 per games in a year before that. I usually do about 8 to 10 in a year now in my 13th season. You asked about my military background. I spent 23 years in the Air Force in computers, all my career in computers, so from room-sized computers to desktop-sized computers. Now your cell phone has more computing power than the ones we had that were room-sized at that time. So.
All right. And so your 13th season, may I ask how old you are?
I'm 61 years old, and I'm planning to live to 100 and want to keep throwing as long as I can. So.
All right. Well, so tell us about some of the changes that you've noticed in how the games operate and how they are and the throwing.
Well, I'm seeing a lot more women coming out, and I would like to see more women either come in new and stay with it or come back to it as masters. As a masters woman, I embrace the idea I'm throwing a 21-pound weight versus a 28-pound weight for the heavyweight for distance and the weight over bar. And I'm frankly, that's behind me. I'm not going to throw a 28-pound weight anymore. But the idea of keeping competing as long as possible, we're also working on my technique, just getting a little better. Of course, over the years, I've noticed that some of my strength is diminishing a little bit, which annoys me, but I'm going to work to keep as strong as I can. But I'd like to let women that are in track and field, for example, in a high school or college level, know there is life after college in throwing, and it can be a lot of fun, because I always describe the Highland Games as a giant throwing track meet where we all wear kilts and throw heavy stuff.
All right. And so tell us some of your biggest successes.
Well, one of the biggest successes I've had is I did take a third place in the Masters World Championships in Calgary in 2011. And I was really pleased with that, especially because of the caber toss, because they could go up in the Canadian Rockies and just get whatever cabers and trees they wanted. And so when they talked about the idea of cutting one so that we could turn it because they weren't going to score degrees, we were just shocked. We said, you're going to cut a caber? Those are so precious. You're going to cut one? And so I was able to finally turn it on my third attempt and was able to be second. Some of my other accomplishments, I dialed in my weights for distance over the years a little bit, so it's been kind of satisfying to outthrow former world championships in the weights for distance when we've been on the field together, even though I'm typically not outthrowing it in some of the other things. But.
Right. So what is your favorite event?
Hammers, generally, because there's no footwork involved. You don't have to move your feet or anything. You just stand there and just kind of get your body dialed in.
What do you think is the event that you're the weakest at?
Difficult. I'd say the weight over bar is tough because of the vertical strengthening. Caber, I find myself the caber because it's technical, but my successes have been built on the idea of picking the caber successfully and getting a toss on it, because every stick is so different that you can never really count on turning it all the time. So.
Okay. All right. And so if you were to, and I know that you have this opportunity very often, but when a new person comes up to you and asks you about the games and if it's something that they would like or if you feel like they would be competent at it, what do you say?
I would say, I am, you know, come with me to practice. I'm able to practice outside of my house, which is tremendously convenient. I try and invite people over to come and practice. I can teach them how to pick and learn how to pick and walk with a caber so they can build confidence in being able to do that. I'm able to help folks, and I'm willing to help them if they want to come out. It's difficult for me, though. What happens at times is, like trying to organize any party, you have a lot of people sometimes that show up, so that's annoying. So sometimes I'm, all throughout my lifting career, throughout my throwing career, I've kind of been on the cusp of where I'm not as strong as the guys, but I'm stronger than more of the women, so I end up tending to be by myself a lot of times because people just don't come or something like that.
Okay. Well, so who has been your mentors?
Sean Betts. Sean Betts, he's a retired pro, but we've been colleagues at work for, I'm a fitness professional, exercise physiologist, we've been colleagues at work for since about 2000, no, about since 1998 time frame, and he's been the person that's kind of mentored me and brought me along as far as giving me ideas and giving me cues that helped me improve my weight for distance. I've been about the seventh year of doing it, he gave me a cue that has just really paid off, and that's where my weights for distance started to get really solid. So. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so how has your background in exercise helped you with this?
Exercise, because as an exercise physiologist and my passion is promoting strength exercise, so I want to make sure that I'm getting strong. I've come from a powerlifting background as an adult, okay? I never really felt much of an athlete or anything, but getting strong for look appearance, but also for capability in real life. As I said, I'm planning to live to 100, and so being strong is the best ticket to that. So I want to always stay as strong as possible and do make my exercise workouts be as complementary to my throwing during the season as possible, even in spite of the idea that I might have diagnosed joint issues on one hand or the other. They're of no consequence to me. I'm not too, as far as I'm concerned, they're just findings, and they really aren't limitations as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, all right. So let's say that you're in a room full of fellow athletes. What would you tell them? What advice would you give them from your background and your experience that would help them become better throwers?
To become better throwers, practice when you can. Don't think you have to have a long, huge practice. It doesn't have to go out and throw 50 throws in a time or anything like that. My practices usually, I put more events together, but I may only take about 6 to 8 throws in a practice of a particular event. I may split heavy and light implements into different practices. So practice when you can, and have fun and don't get hurt. That's my mantra about that, especially as a master's. A lot of people, especially some of the gentlemen, they're a little bit more about, you know, throw far, suck less. I'm not into that kind of thing. It's nice to have, you know, friendly banter back and forth, but we're all out here to have fun, don't get hurt, and stay with it for the long term.
Okay, so what's next for Terry?
For Teresa, Chinook, Kansas, next month, the Kansas City Games at the end of May. I expect to do the Highland Game, Melanie Mellander's Heart of America Highland Games at the end of July. Waterloo, the Iowa Irish Fest is one of my favorites because it's a very, very cozy throwing area, and I'm a big hit there. I have fans in Waterloo that look for me every year and come and talk to me, and people on the street will come up and tell me they admire that, and I'm not afraid to tell them how old I am and encourage them. Don't sell yourself short. You could do it too. I always show up for the demo event the night before to just let people try the events and things. So I can, there's no reason to let yourself be held back. If you want to try it, I'm willing to help you try. Okay. So Waterloo is good. Topeka, I'll expect to do. I have a couple of games in September. I'll be back to Wichita in the fall and Kirksville to finish the season. And if I were to hit the qualifiers for Masters World Championships in Tucson, I would plan to do that one. That's always a tough road to hoe with the current standard.
Okay. So any other final thoughts?
Come on out. Have fun. Don't get hurt. Throw heavy stuff and enjoy yourself. That's the biggest thing.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.